It's the Xbox One S All Digital Edition. This version of the Xbox One lacks an optical drive, but has it gained anything in exchange? There's only one way to find out, and that's to tear it down. Flipping the Xbox One S All Digital Edition over, we find a greeting from the fine folks at Microsoft. The first stop to getting your Xbox One S All Digital Edition is to remove a tamper evidence sticker, hoping to find a screw. No screw here, so it looks like we're going to be popping some clips. The next step requires some brute force. The clips holding the lowercase on are quite strong, and our handy plastic spudger was no match for them. Fortunately, our ProTech comes with a metal version that is able to pop all the clips, allowing us to lift the component up and off. Like previous versions of the Xbox One S, all the goodies are enclosed in a metal case, which itself is enclosed in the plastic outer case. To get the metal case out, we need to first remove the 6 long green screws holding everything together. We now have access to the 2 boards connected to the outside of the metal case, which are a front panel board and a Wi-Fi board. Removing a couple more screws allows us to lift the top off the metal case, revealing a very sparse interior. The hard drive bracket and power supply are secured to the bottom of the case with screws, and once you remove them, you can lift the hard drive up and away, revealing their connectors. The hard drive is a standard spinning 5400 RPM 1TB Seagate drive, but if you're thinking about swapping it out for a much faster SSD, we've got some bad news. While it may be fairly easy to access, installing the firmware for the Xbox One S is not an easy task for beginners. The power supply comes out next, and its specs seem to match the power supply we found in the original Xbox One S. Looks like no changes here. We remove the last of the screws and lift the motherboard out of the metal case. This springy X bracket is all that's holding the fan and heatsink to the motherboard, and once we pop it off, we're able to separate them. On the board, we can spot the 8-core Jaguar CPU, which runs at 1.75 GHz, and the 8 GB of SK Hynix made RAM. With our Xbox One S All Digital version disassembled, it's time to talk repairability. The Xbox One S All Digital scored an 8 out of 10, and here's why. On the upside, only a few tools are required to take the whole console apart. Once inside, a clean, no-nonsense modular design allows the hard drive, fan, heatsink, PSU, wireless board, and front daughter board to be easily replaced. Fewer interlocking body panels and a simpler clip arrangement make opening this generation of Xbox easier than the original Xbox One. But on the downside, replacing the hard drive will require some difficult hackery to make it serviceable.